the Hogan's Slam.
I need to talk to you about your mom and her.
This album is different from the first album.
17-year-old son Nick is in jail. He's sentenced to 8 months.
First of all, because I got to write it myself. The last one we kind of, I don't want to say threw it together, but you know, I was in the hands of Scott Storch and he kind of led the way a little bit too much. And this one, I feel like I was just myself and I got to put together what I wanted. And I think that that's going to create a better result in, you know, people's reactions and, you know, respect too. This is the redemption. My family was a really big part of this album. My mom really was, because the past 2 years that my parents have been going through a very nasty divorce, my mom and I have had a major falling out. So I wrote about that. My dad was part of my inspiration just because he's so strong and he really showed me the way when there wasn't one in my mind. You know, when I thought that I was doomed and my mom had, you know, left me and I was living alone in Miami and, you know, that's it. My dad was like, you know, you have to move on. You have to pick yourself back up. He gave me the strength, basically. He instilled good morals and, like I said, strength in me. So that's, I think, what got me through this album.
Said that you wanted a change, was it true? And do it to save all we had, or would you? How could you give up? How could you do that? Why did you leave me? And when you come back, spending all your time with him, you can't even see me.
I have a track on the album called Dear Mom, and it was inspired by my mother and our trials and tribulations, you know, that we've gone through. And those aren't really resolved yet. And I feel like she's kind of had a selfish, I don't know. She's just been very selfish through the whole situation with the divorce and how she's, you know, dealt with her kids and the whole family side of things. And she just kind of up and left. So I wrote a song called Dear Mom, and it really was just a heart to heart between me and a piece of paper, and it came out in the song. So sometimes I listen to it and I think, you know, oh God, that's a little harsh, but it's how I really feel. You know, I've never been able to really just be myself and say what I feel, and this album is that. So Dear Mom is strong, but it's true and it's real, and I'm not lying. I have a couple features on the album. I have two Sobe artists, one Stax, who is a big part of my heart, and I have another guy, Urban Mystic, who is on Sobe, who's very talented, and he's that old school R&B kind of voice, so I definitely wanted to work with him since all my training came from an R&B background. And then I have Flo Rida and Colby Adonis.
The only part I think is just the end where you said, yeah, just for orchestra purposes, like for, yeah, makes my day, yeah, 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 yeah. Gorgeous, yeah. Gorgeous, baby.
Hey, it makes my day, yeah.
Very, very, very talented people, and it was really cool to work with all of them. And this album, I really tried to surround myself with just pure talent and people who were really genuine and really nice, you know, instead of having people with egos and stuff like that. I just wanted to surround myself with good people, and that's what we did. And we have a great album because of it. I think my favorite track on the album, I can't pick because I wrote most of them and a lot of them are really close to my heart, but I think I have three favorite tracks on the album. I have one that I wrote called Rough Me Up. Judgment Day, and at first we didn't even plan on releasing mixtape. That wasn't even part of the game plan, and we got a couple of calls from people from our past, meaning me and Sobe and Unique and or Stax and Jit and everybody on Sobe. We've all kind of had some haters because, you know, this album's getting, you know, a lot of attention from some of the tracks that are on there. You know, of course the TV exposure doesn't help, but, well, it does, you know, but it doesn't. And we just had a lot of phone calls from some people in our past that were just hating on us and talking shit. So I was like, you know what? We gotta call them out. So Stax was like, let's put together a mixtape and just call it Judgment Day, you know, before the Redemption, you gotta have Judgment Day. And we're basically just calling everybody out that has ever hurt us or betrayed us or taken advantage of us. And honestly, to be in, you know, the spotlight my whole life with a famous father and watching, you know, the free dinners and the, you know, the help and the stuff that my dad has always done for other people, and then you get no love back. And also, you know, Stax's family has had to go through that, and it just seems the higher you climb, the more people want to bring you down. So we were just like, fuck you guys. We're gonna just call you out and whatever, we don't care. Everybody has been asking me about the diss on Heidi Montag, and I personally never had anything against Heidi, and I don't. Do I think she's cut out for singing? No. I think she should stick to acting. But a certain producer that she's working with used to work with me, and he had the guts to call Sobe Entertainment and I out and basically just say that we were quote-unquote playing in shit. and you know, that Heidi was gonna take over and, you know, basically squash Brooke Hogan, and, you know, their whole team was so much better than us, and really it was just uncalled for, and we didn't ask to start a fight. So the producer that represents her ended up bringing her name into it, and I was like, well, you know, if you think she's so great, if you really have, if you're really putting all your eggs into that basket, then let me show you what I think about that. So that's what I did. And what people don't know yet, but they will, and I'm talking to you guys, if you go onto brooksworld.com, the first 100 copies that are ordered of the album are going to be signed by me. So, The Redemption, coming out July 21st. And I hope that you guys can make it out to my album release parties. They're both going to be here in Miami. One is at the Hollywood Hard Rock in Hollywood. And it's at Club Opium on July 25th. And then we're going to have another one here on South Beach at Club Mansion on the 31st. So I hope that you guys can come. I really hope to see you. And go grab the album on the 21st.
Maybe you don't know the girl that's coming out of me. I don't like it nice and slow, I want it rough, you see. Boy, I know we love each other, always pleasing one another. But I have just one request, pull